action again last night against Stoke City, where some familiar faces were on parade. Here's Clive Tilsley.
As we all know only too well, Saint, football is now a young man's game. Seniors like Mickey Thomas and Alan Ball belong on the sidelines with the rest of us. But Thomas has always been the exception to football's rules. The game's oldest teenager is still going strong with Stoke City.
Oh, I, well, everyone's getting the nick about me, so I've got to quite keep laughing when you get called an old man when you're going down the wing. I'm a young 36.
How long are you going to go on?
Well, I'm looking to play more than Stanley Matthews. He was 50, so you're going to go for 51 if I can.
Stoke City are just one of 10 famous clubs who've caught a bout of Mickey's infectious enthusiasm. But an early penalty award for Tranmere last night was enough to wipe the smile off even his face. Handball against Paul Ware. Not the last harsh decision of the night either. Tranmere's Ian Muir scores goals for fun. Penalties are just target practice to him. But Stoke aren't planning to hang around. It's only their second ever season in the third division. Tony Ellis with a head and hope. Mickey Thomas adding the celebrations. They were in front by half time. A second penalty just before the break settled it. This time Tranmere's Mark McCarrick was judged guilty of the sleight of hand. Well, they say the decisions even out eventually. Mick Kennedy, another of Alan Ball's summer signings, did the necessary. 2-1, the final score. Thomas's legs didn't quite see out the night. He spent the final 4 minutes at the side of his manager after being substituted. There was no substitute for their experience, whatever the division. Ball and Thomas are proving a winning combination.
Well, you know, he's been my hero as a young boy. But he's probably saying it now about me, you know, because he played when he was 38 and he's given me a lot of experience, you know, helping that. And it's helping, really.
You can see that passion, can't you, on the bench in the last couple of minutes?
Yeah, well, he's football daft as well, you know, and I think that's the way to be. You've got to love this game to be still in it, and that's why I'm still playing at 36 and that.
Are still seeking their first league win too. Luther Blissett looked to have put them on their way against Stoke with a penalty. But Derek Statham ended their hopes with an equaliser 6 minutes from time, one apiece.
Statham cutting that one out. Oh, Sanford's giving it to Morley. Allen's racing through. Chance here for Allen, maybe. In comes Keane. Keane shoots, stopped by Blake. And then over the line from Sanford. Butler. Kelly chasing through. That'll. Oh, McCloskey. There's a chance here for Beeston. Shoots. Oh, well wide of the target. And Carl Beeston, he can't believe it. Slater. Good cross by Slater. Allen with the header. This is Morley. Oh, and Morley hauled down. Penalty it is. Sanford hauled him down as he turned and attempted to shoot. So Julian Dix, with 2 minutes to go to the interval, has the opportunity here of shooting West Ham United into a lead this evening against Fox. Yes, he can. Hit it with venom. And look at that little wiggle. Julian Dix shoots West Ham United into the lead. Slater. Oh, beautiful ball for Kevin Keane. Hit the strike. Oh, a perfect goal from Kevin Keane. Beautifully teed up by Stuart Slater. And that's just the tonic that young Keane wanted. His first goal of the season. Beeston. Oh, that was offside. And a chance here. Oh, brilliant save by McCloskell. Paul Ware hit his shot hard and true, and McCloskell springs into action to turn that one over brilliantly. Fowler dispossessed there by Kevin Keane. An early ball from him to Morley, sets up Quinn, and Quinn! Oh, what a finish from Jimmy Quinn! That was absolutely superb! This is what KLF is about. Also known as the Justified Ancients of Moomoo. Furthermore known as a jam.
The short one finds. And that's a goal for Stoke. Headed in by Mick Kennedy.
First, we join the third division's biggest crowd of the day as second place Grimsby meet third place Stoke. Nick Powell.
On an afternoon where tension may well be much in evidence, Stoke will rely on experienced men like Mickey Thomas, scorer of the winning goal at Bradford in midweek. But even at 36, he's not the oldest player on the field. That's Steve Sherwood in the Grimsby goal, whose efforts last week at Birmingham did much to earn his side a point. Right by Statham. Well won by Cunnington, the captain. And Woods found Gilbert in a little bit of space. It's a good turn by Gilbert, asking Rees to have a go. Goalkeeper timed his run well, Peter Fox, and down bravely and timed it exactly right. And the Grimsby defence are finding Tony Kelly quite a handful this afternoon. And McDermott didn't know the ball had come to him. Thomas did. Here's Kelly, shooting chance. Still Kelly, came off Sherwood, and it goes for the corner. But the mistake by McDermott very nearly let in Tony Kelly then. Paul Ware has come across to take the corner. Help from Thomas. Blake on the far post. Beeston. Carl Beeston, clear shooting opportunity. No challenge. This is Brighter from Woods. Rees inside him. Woods may fancy his chances going on his own. There's Rees inside. Can he turn? Still trying to turn, it must break, and has gone in for Tommy Watson. Stoke will certainly carry the game to them now. Here's Kevin. Space for Ware, chance for him. Couldn't get any power on the shot. Full midfield player. This is Rees. Nice touch for Woods. Good tackle. Still might break for Grimsby. Here's Watson. Childs on the far post. Here's Childs. Gary Childs. And Alan Ball, the Stoke manager in the cap there, must be wondering what he can do. There's not much he can do from the touchline because he's played both substitutes. He must just hope that his team can get forward. Well, he can have a go. Crowd have just been given the attendance of 10,799. As Ellis goes forward, might try a shot. Only a yard wide. Tony Ellis, who got two goals a couple of weeks ago. Thought he might have got one there. Stoke still pressing forward. Thomas. Statham, ball came off Lever. Thomas, worth a try, it's a good effort. And the referee decides that the 90 minutes are up and Grimsby Town have beaten Stoke on an important afternoon. It didn't go their way in the first half. In the second half, goals from Gary Childs and Tommy Watson. There's Gary Childs, back from a spell out with an ankle injury. A happy afternoon for him and for Grimsby. It's Grimsby 2, Stoke City 0.
Youngsters came pouring onto the pitch and started taunting the visiting supporters. The police were unable to stop the Stoke fans getting out of their enclosures, and fighting broke out as the two groups clashed. Officers battled to restore order and mounted police had to be brought in. Today, club officials assessed the damage caused to the ground. The worst was in the away stand, where seats were ripped out and used as missiles. Ironically, many of the problems on Saturday were caused by safety measures brought in after the Hillsborough disaster, allowing easy access to the pitch.
Of course, this does make it easier for the people that want to get onto the ground to get onto the ground at the end of the game. We don't really want to stop this, because in the event of something happening within the stand, we would in fact evacuate onto the pitch. But we would ask that all the various people that come to the ground stop this minority hooligan element from entering the premises and causing the problems that happened on Saturday.
Meanwhile, the man in charge of the police operation has refuted claims that they didn't act quickly enough when the trouble first broke out.
The police operation was entirely successful.
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough. And things go wrong no matter what I do. Now and then I feel like life is just too much. But you've got the love I need to see me through. When food is gone, you are my daily meal. Mm-hmm. When friends are gone, I know my Savior's love is real. Your love is real. Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air.
Well, when the draw was made for this first round, one of the best ties to come out was Telford United against Stoke. Telford with one of the best non-league records in the Cup. Stoke playing in this round for the first time in over 60 years, and of course a local derby as well. In Telford's team, two men who played for Stoke, number 3 Dyson and player-manager Daly, who named himself as sub today. And in Stoke's team, Derek Statham, Noel Blake and Mickey Thomas, all with bags of First Division experience behind them.
And it came off Blake, back again to Nelson. Crawley's at the far side, so is Myers here. That's his cross, Nelson! Franson. Biggins. Beeston! Well, there was an opening for Stoke City. The strikers proving a bit of a handful there for the Telford defence. Beeston was the player on the end of things. So there are 6 yellow shirts in there to aim at. One of them is Cranson. Blake's also in the thick of it. Biggins. Sanford! Got right underneath it as Jim McDonough came out to close him down. Fowler. Takes on Nelson. Good pace. Oh, what a poor throw by McDonough. Sanford got in the way. This is Thomas. Biggins closing. Ellis surely must score. Oh, brilliant defending. Paul Dyson. Ellis thumps the ground. He looked odds on to tuck it in. But Dyson, a splendid interception and deflection, in fact, saves Telford. Thomas. Kennedy's cross. Oh, they're under siege now at Telford. Here's Beeston. Fowler begins. Thomas. Wide again to Fowler. Ellis has got his arm up in the middle. There he is! Well, Tony Ellis must feel the FA Cup owes him a bit of luck. He was in the Preston side last year, beaten by Whitley Bay in front of our cameras. And Stoke now have a free kick. Over Blake's head. Mickey Thomas. Blake, deflection on that. And a real scramble here. In goes Blake again. Beeston! It won't go in for Stoke. Or Carl Beeston. Their supporters have seen the ball whistle around that goal now on several occasions. Myers. Daly. And the referee blows. And Stoke City and Alan Ball preserve their third division respect against the GM Vauxhall Conference Club. Maybe Stoke could have won it in the second half, but their former player Paul Dyson made an outstanding clearance right in front of goal, and so the tie goes back to the Victoria Ground, Stoke, on Wednesday night for a replay.
They do and find Biggins. Good turn by Biggins, and he's making some good progress. No challenge coming in as Biggins gets to the edge of the area. He finds Ellis. Over comes the cross. Header from Thomas. Stoke City have taken the lead. Mickey Thomas, the man who's given it. 2 minutes into the second half. Robinson, very looking for that opening. Cross, chance, and it's there! Lovely cross by Liam Robinson. McKinley was on the end of it.
Didn't last the night as his Stoke side went down 2-0 at Burnley, both goals in the last 18 minutes. John Francis scoring from an impossible angle, a shot deflected in off a defender. Burnley wrapped it all up with Winston White's goal 3 minutes from time to claim the prize of a home tie against First Division Manchester City in round three.
Chance here for Stoke to go in front, and they have. Goal by Tony Ellis.
Dear, oh dear. Well, none of the Orient challenges hard enough there. And once again, Vince Hilaire. Room for the cross, which he gets in there. Golden opportunity, 2-0. Mickey Thomas, I think, with the header.
What can you do for me? What can you do for me? What can you do for me? ball from Stringfellow to Christie. Christie, a good ball through for Ian Hathaway. He's onside. Can he get the better of the mud? Can he get the better of Butler? He's got a chance now and he scored. Marvellous finish from Ian Hathaway and beautifully found from Trevor Christie.
Griffiths now crossed it in. Daly inside the area. 1-0. Phil Daly, great goal. So Stoke still only one behind as Wigan go forward. You really do feel though there could be more goals for Wigan. Good ball from Tankard. Griffiths now looking to tee himself up. Brian Griffiths lazy two to Phil Daly. Goal, Phil Daly. Wigan 2, Stoke 0. Phil Jones now crosses that one in. Fox is up for it. Headed in by Patterson. 3-0. And Griffiths just plays the ball to Johnson. Johnson works it out there. Great ball to Jones. Jones, he's got Langley and Page inside. He's got to give it Langley. Jones now. Shoots. No, crosses it in. Page, that's a goal. Dom Page. Yes. His 16th of the season. And he does a little dance as well.
Everybody's free to feel good. Everybody's free to feel good.
Everybody... From the referee. With Stoke down to 10 men, the Cherries hit back. Andy Jones equalised. And Bournemouth went in front 16 minutes later. Substitute George Lawrence headed home. Bournemouth wrapped it up 6 minutes from time, a well-taken goal by Luther Blissett. Final score, Stoke City 1, Bournemouth 3.
sharp on my way. From conviction, no fiction, this is my day. I can move any mountain.
Now here comes Mickey Thomas for Stoke. Oh, there he is. But that's not offside. And that's a goal scored by number 7, Mark Dadley. Ball disallowed at one end. And then Mickey Thomas doing the damage at the other. So the ball player forward to Mickey Thomas, who's took up a forward position for Stoke. Mickey Thomas plays the ball across. Oh, that's a great goal. That's a superb goal scored by Kelly, number 10 Kelly. Stoke City 2, Bolton 0. What a fantastic goal. And plays the ball out wide to Sora. Sora to Steve Thompson. Now, Phil Brown. Oh, he crashed one in there, Phil Brown. And that's a corner kick. But Patterson being spoken to by the referee. And goalkeeper Fox. Yeah, goalkeeper Fox arguing with the referee. Now Julian Darby plays the ball to Phil Brown. Phil Brown plays it in. Now Julian Darby. Yes, it's there. Jules, as they call him at Burnley Park. Stoke City 2, Bolton Wanderers 1, and that's Julian Darby's. Now Phil Scott plays the ball for Scott Green. Scott Green for Reezy. Come on, Reezy. Blast straight, Reezy. Oh, now Storer. Yes! Stuart Storer! Ball Wanderers 2, Stoke City 2.
For half an hour it was edgy stuff, and then the strike by Wayne Clark, First Division vision, to free Tony Kelly, and with a little help from the Mansfield defence, the opening goal. Mansfield fans tried their best to encourage, but this was a truer reflection of the first half. The club's president and most famous ex-player settled for the second half. Suddenly, there were three goals in 14 minutes. The equaliser from a Christie cross, Ford setting up Mark Smalley with his markers nowhere. It proved an inspiration to Stoke. A free kick floated to the head of Noel Blake, and that was 2-1. Wayne Clark's second apparently put the match beyond doubt. A delicate header of real class. But Stoke, as on Saturday, kamikaze to the end, almost let Mansfield back in. It was good luck and not good management that kept the ball out. They held on for the remaining 5 minutes and for three vital points. Most of the 10,000 made their way home happy. For Graham Paddon, it's 9 without defeat now, eyes firmly fixed on becoming the full-time boss.
Well, I'm that now, temporarily or what, but, you know, I'm not getting any grey hairs at the moment.
Sir Stanley, meanwhile, and his host could afford to smile. The days of his special class are the days of football past. Graham Paddon right now will settle for a return to the second division and the manager's job.